सर माझा पहिला प्रश्न की तुम्ही जेव्हा 28 च्या वयात डॉक्टरेट केलं
हो लवकर केलं
सो व्हॉट इन्स्पायर टू यू टू बी अ डॉक्टर
लेट मी टेल यू दॅट माय फर्स्ट लव इज अकॅडमिक परस्यूट्स अँड इन ऑर्डर टू बिकम फुल प्रोफेसर अँड इन ऑर्डर टू सी दॅट आय एन्जॉय माय अकॅडमिक लाईफ आय नीडेड अ डॉक्टरल डिग्री
ओके
व्हेन आय गॉट पीएचडी I got promotion. I became vice principal and principal.
Hmm.
Thereby, I could interact with students more freely and I enjoyed that interaction.
Okay.
Yeah, that was the point.
Sir, it was at a very young age, at the age of 28.
Hmm.
You are 92 young,
yes.
You know, today.
Yes.
So at this age, you are so sprightly, energetic.
Yes.
So what inspires you to continue coming to the office even now?
My dear girl, if the people around you like you, they are my inspirators. They always say that I must work hard, I must come here, and I meet so young students here. That's why, though I am 92, I feel that I am not 92, but I am just 32. And I try to deliver my talk with these young students. I enjoy that. And I, my health is all right, and therefore I feel that age is not a problem. Problem is whether you have got inspiration. And I strongly believe that commitment is my culture, confidence is my creed, and thirdly, innovation is my tradition.
Wow.
Every time I try to make new changes in my teaching, in my language, and in my relationship with others.
Wow.
This innovation has helped me. Innovation, no, it requires creativity. And my strong point is, I feel, honestly, I have a lot of creativity. Why do I have creativity? It is because I have got a curiosity about this world. Even at this age, I try to collect information. Curiosity. Once you have got curiosity, automatically you lead to creativity.
Right.
And creativity leads to innovation.
Perfect.
That is what I mean. Yes.
Perfect, sir. Perfect. So in your experience, what is more important, aptitude or attitude?
Both are important. But if you ask me pointedly, aptitude or attitude, I think attitude is more important. This is my opinion. If your attitude is favorable, then you are go ahead and aptitude automatically comes in. Aptitude automatically comes in. Attitude is more important.
Okay.
Say if you are not inclined to study your work, finish your work. Attitude is important.
Fabulous. Sir, you have been a guide to more than 98 PhDs,
yes.
Right? 98 PhDs,
yes.
Doctorates,
yes.
You have been the guide to.
It's a world record.
Wow! Sir, so when you have been the guide to so many academicians,
yes.
What would you conclude that what is more important? Have you seen successful people who have got a very strong background of academics? Or is there something else which has made them successful today?
Most of them had got academic background, though they were from industry. From out of these 98 students, some of them were from industry. Some of them are from different fields. But common thing was that they had aptitude, academic aptitude, and they wanted to learn. I have today just now one more student who is himself 70 years old.
Oh.
But he is studying. Very keen. Very soon he will be submitting his thesis after 2 months or so. This aptitude is more important. Why this old man who is 70 years old, why should he require PhD?
Right.
He is a retired government officer.
Right.
And still is doing it.
Right.
And when I look to the young people, I find these young students, they don't have inspiration to develop aptitude. They require some kind of a guidance from people like you. And from this point of view, Swayambhu is a project which inspires young students. You are doing a right social work.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, this is important. The word Swayambhu itself shows that you are encouraging the young boys to become independent, to learn on their own.
Yes.
Either to become enterprisers or to get a good job.
Right.
To my mind, entrepreneurship is more important.
Perfect.
I find that very few people become enterprises.
Hmm.
But I have seen
where
some of the young people who did not have any education, they become enterprises. Enterprises. I have today just now, who is running beauty parlor, having 10 people working under him. He started in a small capacity in Poppyland, and he started in a small way. What was he? He was Jaduwala. I am going to write a biography on him.
Okay.
There are many such people. So I feel happy when somebody likes to become enterprise. I too wanted to, but my parents did not permit me. When I completed my BCom, I tried to sell some of the things in the local train. I have given this in my autobiography. But then I found that academic life was more important, and so I left that. Otherwise, I would have become enterpriser. But young students today, particularly Marathi speaking students, they should become enterprises. There is a scope for them. Thanks to the startup scheme started by the government.
Right.
So many other schemes. Loans are being given by the government.
True.
Now there is a scope for these young students to get funds, to get loans.
Right.
And to start on their own. But they require some kind of a confidence.
Right.
And guidance. Those who guide, they do not give them confidence.
Just
as Vicky White said, innovation apart, confidence should be your tool.
Right.
Confidence should be your strong point.
Right.
That is what is lacking. Commitment should be the, that is what is lacking.
Right.
That is the thing. What else?
Sir, you did not have a background of, entrepreneurs. You had a very humble beginning.
Yes.
Right? So, you have mentioned in your biography, and you have also mentioned at various platforms that you started during your school days, I think.
I have done small job.
Right.
As I said, I was selling crackers, patake, in local trains. I was selling ulbasni in local trains because I wanted money. Then I was selling in Mumbai. I was in Mumbai at that time.
Right.
And in Mumbai, the whole of Mumbai, I used to sell scented supali. That's why I was becoming an enterpriser. But then I thought, my real spirit is to become teacher. So I left that work, did my MCom. Because of it, I became lecturer. Later on, I became professor. And then I found that I can inspire these young students to become enterprises.
Right.
And every time I hear lectures on enterprises in the class, I used to insist that a student should become enterprises. And I find Marwari students, Gujarati students, they are enterprises. They don't take up the job.
Right.
I have got so many Marwari and Gujarati students in BNCC, Gurugram Master College of Commerce. And they never take up the job.
Right.
So in their blood it is there. In Marathi speaking, they are not taking risk at all. They should take the risk.
Right. Sir, you mentioned that you wanted to get into entrepreneurship, and then you understood your spirit is more into academics and teaching. So there are kids or citizens who are not quite sure what their spirit is all about. They are very confused. Right from their young age to maybe till the end of life. So how do you get this confusion resolved?
People like you or Swayambhu project, they should have a lot of interaction with young people. Develop confidence in them. Tell them, go ahead, don't worry. They require some backup. And if they do it, they will come up. They are left alone. They have no guidance.
Right.
That's why I have appreciated your Swayambhu.
So you are the one who inaugurated it,
yes.
Launched it. You
yes.
are the one who introduced me to the word Swayambhu
yes.
in 94, sir.
Yes. No, Swayambhu project is something unique. It should get wide publicity. There should be many Swayambhu projects. One Swayambhu is not enough for this whole world. But I don't know how many people like you will come up with Swayambhu project.
Sir, with your blessings, we have got many Swayambhu mentors who have connected with us.
Yeah.
And they are helping kids to get you know, guidelines on how to go about in
yes,
various fields
right.
and industries.
Yeah.
And by the grace of God, we are able to give internship to many, many aspiring
right,
Swayambhu,
right.
sir.
You have heard about Gita Poonawalla?
Yes, sir.
She has developed so many young girls.
Hmm.
Some of them became enterprises.
Hmm.
Some of them went abroad.
Hmm.
To begin with, these girls were ordinary.
Hmm.
They did not have any support.
Hmm.
Gita Poonawalla came forward.
Hmm.
And she did a lot of things. I have got friendly relations with Gita Poonawalla. She comes here very often.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Hmm.
Sir, as a parting message at this interview, is there anything you would like to share with the young citizens of our country, sir?
I would say that the future of this country
hmm.
and the future of the young people, that is very bright.
Hmm.
In spite of
hmm.
whatever things, wrong things that are happening,
hmm.
the future is very bright. The only thing is,
hmm.
these young people, you should try to find out
hmm.
how to enrich their potential.
Hmm.
They have got a potential,
hmm.
but they don't know what their potential is.
True.
They must discover the potential,
hmm.
develop the potential,
hmm.
utilize the potential
hmm.
for them and for the society.
Right.
If they do it,
right.
I feel that the young people will be great asset to the nation.
Right.
We are wasting our time. We have got a good large population of young people. The total population of young people in India
yes.
is much more
hmm.
than the population of other countries.
True.
So why not we are wasting our education from that point of education field
yes,
is not
sir.
Doing anything concrete in this field.
Hmm.
Primary education, secondary education.
Hmm.
It is at this stage
hmm.
that they will inculcate the spirit of Andhra Pradesh.
Right.
The point is, nobody is around them.
Hmm.
Everybody curses them. Everybody says, oh, so you have no future.
Hmm.
Don't say like that.
Hmm.
They have a future.
Hmm.
That is what I feel.
Sir, you have written multiple books in English and Marathi.
Yes.
So, from me, an earnest request, since we have many aspiring Swayambhus who come from Maharashtra and may not be well versed in English, sir, Marathi madhe tanna kai message dila tar maji request hai, sir.
Marathi madhe mi evadha sanghen ki aajcha tarun pidhila ki tarun pidhi amchi rashtrachi, deshachi, samajachi prerak shakti hai. Ya tarun pidhila प्रेरणा देणारं लोक कोणीतरी पाहिजे खूप लोक पाहिजे असं नाही या तरुण पिढीला चांगणार आहे त्यावे तुझं भविष्य चांगलं आहे तू तुझं अंतरण को ट्राय टू फाइंड आउट व्हॉट 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 इज देअर तुझ्या मगाशी बोललो नाही एव्हरी वन कोटे सुप्त शक्ती प्रत्येकाजवळ
काय सर
सुप्त शक्ती पोटेन्शियल
ओके
सुप्त शक्ती इनर पॉवर सुप्त शक्ती तुमच्याजवळ आहे ती शोधून काढा ती वाढवा आणि ती समाजासाठी तुमच्या घरी वापरा वाव 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 आहे आणि इथे मला वाटतं की काही प्रमाणात स्वतः स्वतः निश्चय विचार करायचे प्रत्येकाला दुसरा नाही आपल्याला मार्गदर्शन करा असं नाही मला कुणी केलं होतं मार्गदर्शन मी अत्यंत गरिबीत वाढलेलो आहे लहानपणी मान विकलेलं आहे नंतर मला कोणी विचारलं काय सांगितलं काही नाही माझा मी विचार करायला लागलो की मला कर्ज कोणाकडनं कोणावर अडवून राहायचं नाही मी माझं शिकत
राहणार
पैसे उरत सांगितलं शिकलो आणि शिकल्यानंतर पहिल्या मी त्यांना प्राध्यापक झालो का मला मुलांशी बोलायचं मुलं ही माझी दैवत आहेत मुलांना मी देव मानतो आणि माझ्या मुलांना मी खूप वाढवलं असं मला अभिमान आहे अपवाद काही सोडले तर माझी सगळी विद्यार्थी सगळी मुलं मला अभिमान आहे की खूप मोठी झाली असं हे आहे
सर तुमचे विचार तुम्ही शेअर केल्याबद्दल खूप 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 धन्यवाद सर आणि सर आमच्याकडून आणि सर्व स्वयंभू मेंटर्स कडून आणि जे अस्पायरिंग स्वयंभू आहेत त्यांच्याकडून तुम्हाला बेस्ट विशेस फॉर अ लॉंग हेल्दी फॅन्टॅस्टिक लाईफ अहेड. सर
जगायचं काय माहिती का?
हो सर.
अजून मला तरुण पिढीला प्रेरणा द्यायची.
येस सर.
मला माझ्याकरता जगायचं नाहीये, मी पुष्कळ जगलो, पण असं वाटतं मला तरुण पिढी करता करायचं.
येस सर. तुमच्यामुळे सगळ्यांना आपला इनर पॉवर मिळू दे आणि आमच्यासारख्या लोकांना तुमच्यामुळे स्फूर्ती येऊ दे अजून. थँक्यू सर. थँक्यू सर.
थँक्यू सो मच.